What's going to happen is you're going to end up going out there fighting other travellers, bigger families, weapons involved. We don't have any backup, son.
Well, whose fault is that then?
Something I want you to fucking know.
There's Martina. What's the matter with you? Don't worry, man, you'll never see this. Just come out, we'll get you some practice in. You can be a proper man for Martina.
Trying to help me. I'm okay.
You know things are changing, don't you?
Yeah.
You need to start doing your exams. Being able to give a few blows and take a few blows, that'll make a man of you, won't it? Huh?
Let's do that again.
This happened to me. This is about my experience of living in Ireland and what it means to be an Irish traveller over the last 40 years.
You never know what they're up to. Do you have everybody in this side of Fredland?
I've been writing the play for about 3 years, and I suppose as a young one, when I heard other writers talking about how long they took to write a play, I used to think, what were they doing? I suppose, for me, first of all, I didn't know what way it would turn out. I'm still not sure what way it's going to turn out.
Where are you? It's
one of the first things I ever wrote was a poem. I actually didn't know I could do this, and someone else found it. I didn't show it to anyone. And it was a love poem. And I got to think, oh yeah, it's like teenage nonsense. But at the time I remember thinking, this is a good way to get out what you need to get out. Well, I like reading, and I think it's probably one of the best gifts anyone can have. Some of the books I kind of like to read, and I'm a bit embarrassed by this, and romance with an ethnic twist to it, and black and ethnic, and Asian writing would be my favourite, particularly because I can identify with the roles of women. And also, I mean, I tried to, again, this doesn't, I hope it doesn't sound too pretentious, but sometimes I try to push myself and read something a bit more heavy going. One book a week. But I have little favourites that I read over and over again. A lot of people now talk about reading books about Buddha and all that. I could never relate to that. I think a book or a novel, something has to happen. You know, you have to be engaged with it, I suppose. My temperament is not about wanting to be calm or chilled out. But particularly now, with the play coming up, I find that the only way to relax and calm myself is to kind of force myself to read something. Those moments of quietness and get 2 chapters done and, you know, stop thinking about the play. And also just learning how to do plots, how to develop characters, how to connect storylines. That sort of stuff you learn from reading.
Yeah, I am. I mean, next you're going to be telling me if the bomb do you home or... Ah, it's dead. So maybe that box will make a fan out of you. Well, someone needs to hit you on the right side of the head and remind you who you are.
Fuck off, dude.
And when my mother was very ill, she was in the hospital. And this particular day I was visiting my mother, and she had Alzheimer's. And we were both in the room. I couldn't help her. She couldn't respond to me. And that was a moment where being stuck manifested itself. People caught up in a situation where all of them have a history, all of them are never going to be the same because of one event. It's also about a young man and his struggle with his loyalty to the community, loyalty to his father, loyalty to his identity. But being really in love with one of his classmates, who's a settled woman, and what that does to him. It would have been much easier to write a play without it being Travellers. It would have been so easy in university to pass as a settled, disabled woman. It would have been really comfortable not to get angry or upset when people used humour or whatever around Travellers. I'm in a really privileged position. My family have been really supportive. I'm at an age where I don't care. I've proved my credibility and my loyalty, and my love for my ethnicity. That's why I really like working with Jason Burns. Other directors may have felt this is a sensitive piece of work. He didn't approach the work like that. He was treating it as a piece of theatre rather than an autobiography. So therefore, it was much easier for me to let go of it. I'm the fourth eldest of a family of 20, and I lived at home sporadically. You know, I was in special school for disabled children, which was residential. I would have went home on holidays or whenever my family could take me. I was at home enough that I have been lucky enough to have that bond or that emotional connection where a lot of my friends who had similar experiences leaving their family had said they were strangers, where I would have never felt there would have been a huge amount of love between them and me, or me and them. That's not to say that it didn't bring difficulties, particularly as I got older. There would have been cultural conflicts. There would have been questions around what happened next. My sisters and brothers would have had clear futures around being married, children, whatever. But I just didn't know what what I'm going to do with my life. The biggest question I have in my head around my life and around my family would be, if I wasn't disabled, would they have moved to Dublin? And I know at the time they would have moved to Dublin in the early 80s or whatever. Lots of travellers moved up, but I often wonder, because of that extra pressure on them to get me particular educational services that they couldn't get in rural Ireland. And I often feel a huge source of guilt. Margaret's in Ballymore. It's where we moved to when we moved up to Dublin first. Before that, we travelled and we were on the roadside. So coming to Dublin and moving into a site, it was a real shock to the system. But it was a good thing as well. Being around other travellers, it felt safe. When you're with settled people, and you tell them you were the brothers and sisters, they used to think you were mad. You were an alien. But when you were around other travellers, you know, they had the same. It was the same. Also, it was good weather, and it was just a great fun at that age. And you felt very protected and very loved and very... I suppose it was really nice time of my life. I feel there's that connection anywhere there's travellers. It doesn't have to be verbal. It doesn't have to be a family connection. It can happen anywhere there's another traveller, even if we don't acknowledge each other. But that's more in depth when it's in a site. Our workplace is more connected, is more real, and also it's, you're freer to be who you are. Yeah, I've done really good stuff in my life, or at least I think so, but I've never done that with the pretense of being a settled person, or I've always brought my traveler values and my traveller ethnicity with me. It's like my compass for where I want to go. And I like it, it's grounding. And maybe it's not always explicit, but it's implicit to who and what I am. And the choices I've made. After college, I could have worked in a disability organisation. I could have worked in a women's organisation. I could have worked in lots of settled environments, but I choose not to. My day job, I work for Pally Point Traveller Centre, probably one of the most radical NGOs in Ireland. The unique element of the work of Pally Point is we look at the hard stuff internally in the community. Drugs, violence against women, antisocial behaviour, that whole gamut. I suppose as a traveller feminist, there's lots of stereotypes about, you know, all traveller women are the same and we're all kind of passive, and I think it's not like that. Traveler women are the strongest women I've ever met in my life, and I've met a queer few settled women. As a young woman, I would have felt that desire to be as good as or as smart as settled women. But I always thought, well, if I read too much or learn too much, I'd end up with a settled person's brain. And I didn't want that to happen. This is where I did my degree, theology, philosophy, and biblical studies. And I really loved it here. I had started off in the English department, but I wasn't very good at it. So I moved to theology. I would have been about 25. And in those days, that was considered a mature student. I remember watching a lot of young people that have and feeling very alienated. Although when I look back now, there was only a couple of years between us. But I think for me was, and college was so unexpected. I was so thrilled. It was the biggest achievement I ever had in my life. I still have the letter of acceptance from Trinity. And I suppose I remember thinking, for a lot of people that were here, it was just an extension of secondary school. That college was a rite of passage. It was a norm. But for someone like me, it was like a huge transformation, a huge confirmation of experiences that I never had, but also in terms of I wasn't really politically active in college, but I think my consciousness about human rights, particularly about women's rights, came from my coursework and the stuff I was reading. This is where I grew up. I was here for about 14 and a half years. It feels strange. This is only the second or third time that I've been back. I find it difficult to go inside. So don't forget, this is over 20 years ago. My family may not have always had a good trailer, a good caravan. They may have been living, you know, in Monaghan, Donegal, Sligo. And also my mother would have been pregnant quite a lot. So it wouldn't have been always possible for me to go home on school holidays. I suppose the thing that makes me feel angry about this building or the way this institution was run, it wasn't so much that other institutions were run more harsher or easier. In fact, this was a kind of a clean, safe place, well run by the nuns. But just the lack of educational opportunities, the low expectation, and it was so gendered, specific. The boys did one thing and the girls did another. And yeah, I know it was that time and we've all moved on. But I remember the same moment thinking, I want more, I want to be educated. I'm not sure that an audience giving me a round of applause or a standing ovation can ever take away the hurt. That doesn't go away. So why delve into that part of my life? Something has to remain private and separate. You know, I want to be recognized as a writer, not as a woman whose stuff happens to, and then she wrote about it. That's not how I want it. I'm in the fight. I have a new dress and I have my hair done and my makeup on. Very emotional, very proud, very excited. On last week, it was very emotional, but now it's more excitement. Now there's a bubble in my heart. And I'm loving it, I'm so happy. Having the play stuck going to production. I mean, yeah, I've huge emotions around it, and it came out of a horrible event in my life. My parents died and the barricade in the site and all that went with that. But for me, there's a huge sense of accomplishment.
It's in all of us. You do what you have to do. Selling this shit, yeah, you gotta be careful. But the grade is good. But come on, it's an easier way of making money than dumping Buffer's rubbish.
Sleeping with Buffer's, selling drugs, you're just confused about who you are.
I know who I am. I want a life of travellers. And if that means marrying Martina, then that's what I'll have to do.
You don't even know her and you're gonna marry her.
Once we get engaged, then we'll probably go on a few dates or something. Okay, it's different for travellers.
And when I have a bad day, I can think what I had a play on in the project for 3 weeks. I created something that gave other people jobs and work, that gave people entertainment, I hope.
Do you take them in for questions? Is this what you wanted? They're gonna fucking kill him!
Yeah? But he's not so innocent. Nobody forced him to do anything. If he minded his own business, he wouldn't be in this mess.
I'm sorry, son. I'm sorry. I let you down again. I'm in trouble, son, and I can't keep running.
Stop. victim. I've been really lucky in that I've had inner strength and that I've had people around me, like my family and friends, who have really supported me into making something good of my life. Now I'm an independent, upwardly mobile, chic, minority ethnic woman, and that's a very powerful feeling.